Kyle from WeTech CareOf, and today I'm going to start the mini-series on how to build this invoice generator. So this will be the first session, and for this first session, we're just going to set up the SharePoint lists, and then the next session, so they'll all be separate videos, then to build the Power App, then to build the Power Automate flow. So as I say, for this first session, we're just going to build the SharePoint list, so we'll just get straight into it. So what I'm going to do is I've got a team site here, just created, called form. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to site contents and I'm going to create the first SharePoint list. So I'm just going to create a blank list and I'm just going to call this list invoice system demo. Give that a show in the navigation. So there's our first list. Now what I usually do is I'll remove any spaces from the text so that you can see it comes nice and clean in the URL. And then straight after that's been created, I'll then just insert our spaces. Okay, so this is good. So we've got invoice system demo there, so that's great. First things first, I am just going to rename the title field to be called invoice number. List, then I'm going to add a multi-line text field. So we want to add a column, multi-line text field, and we want to call this bill 2. So I keep it as one word, capital B, capital T. And then just to make sure as well, I usually just make sure that this use enhanced rich text is switched off. So there's our multi-line text field. So then what I do once that's created, we'll just come in here and rename, put the space back into bill 2. Okay, so for the next one, we are going to add a date field. We'll just call that date. In time's fine. Then for the next field, we will just do a single line of text and we'll call this sale amount. I'll put the space in here. GST. And then we want balance due. Now, I assume you'll have noticed that these are all single line of text that I'm using here. The reason I'm using single line of text instead of currency fields is because the way I've built this invoice is once the user enters the numbers, it reformats that and adds the decimal and the thousand separator. So, you know, there's many ways this can be built. If you want to rebuild this to have a currency field for those values, that can certainly be done. Just for this example, I'm using single line of text because it's just easier to put the different data in there. So let me just rename that to be balance due as well. Okay, so that is our first list done. So then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to site contents and I'm just going to create our second list. So there's two lists that we use within this. So I'm going to create another list and this one is going to be from blank and then this one is going to be called invoice system demo tasks. Again, I create that all as one word. That creates a nice clean URL. And then I'm just going to rename, put the spaces in here. Okay, so there's not many fields for this one, in fact. So we've just got our title. We just want to add a multi-line of text called description. We want to add a number field called units. And then we want to add a single line of text field called total amount. And add the space after it's created. Finally, the last field, single line of text called form ID. Now, again, you could use a lookup field to link these two lists. I think I've just found for this example, again, the way I've built this, I'm using a separate field to have these linked between the two lists. I suppose better practice would be to use a lookup column. But yeah, that's how we're going to link this. Obviously, you can see this list is to hold the tasks. So we're going to have, so basically as our architecture, we've got the one invoice system demo list, and then that will link to this tasks list. And then these are the multiple tasks per one invoice system demo, invoice system record. So there's the multiple tasks. So that's everything done now. So we've set up both of our SharePoint lists. So that's the end of this video. See the link in the description for the next video, and that's when we're going to start getting into the automation, getting into the app. Please put any questions if you had any issues with any of this or you need help with anything. And please like and subscribe to the channel, and take care. Thank you.